So good morning to everybody. So I instruct all the students to be silent. Respected chief guest, Mr. E. Father Innareddy Garu, who is a vice president and a great professor in China University, and father has been a great leader in leadership and development qualities of thousands of children in one of the biggest universities in China. And next, the respected chairman, sir, Mr. E. Anthony Reddy Garu, who is the chairman of St. Anthony's and Peter's and Xavier's educational institutions in Sangareddy, Sadashivpet, and in Malkapur. And my dear parents, the teachers, and the students, a very good morning to everybody. Today, I stand proudly to speak a few words about the existence of St. Xavier School for the last 1 year. A small thought in the mind of Mr. E. Anthony Reddy sir has emerged in the month of April 2023 to start an educational institution and to start and to give a standard education not only in the town of Sangareddy and Sadashivpet, but also this kind of holistic development of the child even should reach to the rural areas of surrounding of Malkapur villages, because this has been a request from the thousands of parents in and around Malkapur, parents who have repeatedly requesting the sir to provide a transport facilities to give the education in the surrounding areas. And that thought came into existence and we launched St. Xavier's School on 17th of June 2023 with the chief guest blessing and Dr. J.D. Lakshminarayan Garu. So this education today proudly stands, and all the teachers and the cooperation of the parents, that as a principal of this institution, I can proudly say that the competence level of every student, the standard of education of every student, the communication of every student has increased 30 to 35% from the time of June to till the end of March. And what are the academic standards that we follow during this year is, the first thing that I would like to tell you is, we have introduced a lead school curriculum from nursery to seventh class, where the complete education has been taught through audio visual aid, and every teacher has been supported with a very good tab, inserting and inbuilt the lesson plans with group practices, the individual practices, the resources, which the child gets a lot of interest to learn through the audio visual aids. And the second thing is, apart from that, we have been given to the teacher for every class a school kit, where what are the physical resources of each lesson has been inserted in the school kit, and that are being displayed in the classrooms, where the children have been engaged as a part and parcel of that learning process with the hands of experience with the resources that have been provided. And apart from this, in lead school there are multiple quizzes, the multiple exercises which have been provided to the parents through lead school app, where the child also can get engaged even in the house with the cooperation of the parents. And finally, in the lead school, we have even conducted the lead championship, and that also has been a very good, remarkable participation of our students, and they were also very appreciating of our students the micro projects that they were preparing to showcase in their lead championship. And this is the academic side of the students. The next, coming to the professional enhancement of the teachers. The teachers have been professionally enhanced through various trainings every once in a month, how best education that we must impart to the child through the different routines, the different techniques, to the different teachers' resources, and they have been completely monitored and tracked through their continuous tribular and classroom observation. So this has brought a great change of academic standards in the rural area of Malkapur village in St. Xavier School. So this has been one of the remarkable achievement in nursery to seventh class standards. And the second program that we introduced this year is the math program. The math has been a kind of a difficult subject from the child. If we ask 10 members, what would be your difficult subject at your school level? Out of 10 members, easily 6 to 7 members would say, mathematics is my very difficult subject. So in order to remove that kind of thought from the mind, the mathematics math program has been introduced specially to learn the basic calculations, the basic additions, so that this can be the input of the sums which they are doing in their examination. And this has been also one of the remarkable success program that we have done this year to bring up or to improve their mathematical and numeracy skills in pre-primary level as well as in the primary level. The third program that we introduced this year is the Queen's Language, and that has been brought up a lot of communication change among the students. Today, I can proudly say that my students can stand in front of everybody in assembly, in front of everybody in the programs, and speak out what they have been trained to speak. That has brought a very great change to the Queen's English program. The exercises, one-to-one exercises, and the exercises in the classroom with the help of teachers, and the language that they use would be a development of a very good vocabulary through the Queen's English. So that has also brought a very good development in English language. And the fourth thing is the different programs that we launched. The academic year started with the investiture ceremony. So what do you mean by investiture ceremony? The ceremony which promotes a leadership qualities among a small child. After their graduation, after their post-graduation, one has to be a leader in the society. Whatever the profession that they take, whatever the business that they take, if he has to stand as a leader, if he has to stand as a pioneer, if he has to stand as a frontier, that the quality of leadership seed must be planted in the school level. So that investiture ceremony, dividing all the students into different houses, conducting the various activities on every Saturday. So that promotes a leadership quality among the students. And the fifth thing that I would like to tell you is the educational tours, and the students are being exposed to different universities. Recently, you might have witnessed some of the students have been exposed to Voxen University. Some of the students have been exposed to different schools of our group of chain of schools, where they have been exposed, participated, and they have won a kind of a first prize and second prize on the Science Day and Mathematics Day. And the last, we have done a great student-led conference and student-led movement. I just will tell you in small nutshell, what is the difference between student-led conference and student-led movement. Student-led conference is a basic platform where the student showcases what is their skill. But the student-led movement is a basic platform where we bring a social awareness to the society. So we feel equal responsible not only to teaching the children in the school, at the same time giving awareness to the people in the society. So we have done a student-led movement in different colonies to avoid a complete plastic, because which is going to be a dangerous threat to the future generations. So such kind of student-led movements also have been held with the guidance of sir and teachers and with the cooperation of parents. So these are all the combined programs, these are all combined activities that have brought a great change among the students. Now, today, I would like to announce what are the three new programs which are going to be launched in next academic year 24 and 25. So I request every child to be silent, please. All the children. The three major programs which we are going to introduce next year. The first one is the Pinnacle program from nursery to fifth. What does the Pinnacle program is? Till now we are having a lead school that has been merged with a PSN program, which is a very standardized program and which is very standardized such a way that a child could even compete the international school standards of the children academics in the future. The Pinnacle program, which will have a greater concepts from their primary level, and from third class onwards, we are going to introduce dividing EVS into two subjects, that is science and social. And the second program that we are going to introduce next year is the Spark program. I can tell you the Spark program, the program which has been designed, the universities in United States of America, the design of the program itself gives a complete clarity of communication skill. Suppose the Spark program is nothing but a platform where the child sits in front of the computer and talks to the computer. The scroll of the story goes on the screen of the computer, where he has to speak what is the scrolling going on the computer. If any pronunciation of the word has been mispronounced or misheard, the computer itself stops the child and corrects him and tells him to pronounce the word till he pronounces it correctly. And even the recording that he is speaking over the system will be inbuilt tracked, and those recordings also which will be sent to the parents. This program has been a great success in St. Anthony's Vidyanagar, St. Peter's and St. Anthony's Sadashivpet, that we could see a tremendous change of annotation and the pronunciation of the students, that the parents are really very, very happy. The accent that they were using is completely shocked by the parents, that is this my child speaking such a good English? So such kind of program that we are going to introduce in St. Xavier's, even 24 and 25. And the third program, that major program that we are going to introduce, is as per the aligned with National Educational Policy, that is called NEP 2020, the central government started this initiative mostly to frame the children to have a kind of a skilled education in the future. Because manamu, mana tarala vallu ela chadukunnamante book lo unna vishayalu chadukovatam, parikshalu rayatam, tarvata vaati dwara manam jobulu pondatam. Kani ippudunna competition world lo manam enta chadivina, manaku enta knowledge unna, ఆ స్కిల్ ద్వారా మనకి బాహ్య ప్రపంచానికి కనుక మనం చెప్పకపోతే మనకున్న నాలెడ్జ్ మొత్తం వేస్ట్. సో దాన్ని దృష్టిలో పెట్టుకొని వీ హ్యావ్ టైడ్ అప్ విత్ ఎ ఉలిప్సు ప్రోగ్రామ్, విచ్ ఈస్ కంప్లీట్లీ ద స్కిల్ బేస్డ్ ప్రోగ్రామ్ ఫ్రమ్ ఫస్ట్ క్లాస్ టు సెవెంత్ క్లాస్ స్టాండర్డ్, వేర్ ద చైల్డ్ హ్యాస్ టు చూస్ ద 5 to 7 స్కిల్స్ లైక్ వెబ్ డిజైనింగ్, ఫార్మేషన్ ఆఫ్ ఎ మెయిల్, పవర్ పాయింట్ ప్రెజెంటేషన్, artificial intelligence, information and technology. So according to the range and intelligence capacity of the student, the child has to choose 5 to 7 skills, and he has to appear the practicals in the computer lab, has to complete that skill into 6 to 8 periods, where he will be awarded with the certificates, and that will be continued even in their further classes, so that at this small age that the child learns the skill oriented education in the third standard, fourth standard and fifth standard onwards. So these are the three major programs that we are going to introduce next year. The first one is the Pinnacle program, and the second one is the Spark program, and the third one is the Ulipsu soft skills program. So these three skills along with the sports, with the complete approach of curriculum, that we do not just teach the sports as we give them some balls to play in the ground. That has not been taught in our institutions. Even the sports also are taught as a part of a curriculum. How do we teach in the class? We start with introduction, we go with the teaching-led conference, we go with the group practice, we go with the individual practice, and we go with the conclusion. At the same time, even the sports also have been taught. First, they have a little warm-up, and let them go for the group, and let them have a competition, and let them conclude it. So even the sports also is a major crucial role for the physical development of the child, and that has also been as considered as an important part to teach even the sports also as a the regular curriculum with the esteemed coaches by the great Academy of Sports. So these are the new programs that we are going to launch for the next academic year, and Wholeheartedly, I can proudly say that and acknowledge that the children who study in St. Anthony's Group of Institutions, Peter's and Xavier's Group of Institutions, that in the future, the child will definitely stand in the heights where he can compete the students who are coming out with the international standards. So for this, I specially thank our chairman, sir, Mr. Yantharedi, sir, who has been the source of inspiration and providing a lot more platforms for the rural educational standard education to the children. So let's all give a big round of applause to chairman, sir, who has been a thirst to give the best education even in the rural education. And the last and finally, before my conclusion of the speech, I would specially thank all the parents. Really, today I am blessed in this school to have such a great cooperative and committed parents who always come to the school and discuss with about the child and gives us the suggestions. And they also become the part and parcel of our St. Xavier's family, that together let's develop the child. So they come and discuss with me as a principal, they come and discuss with the staff, and they come and discuss with the children and their core friends. And finally, I am blessed to have such a great cooperative parents who continuously support us, and they also still say that let's all bring a children into a great heights. And finally, last, I would also thank my teachers. My teachers have been professionally enhanced so much. In the beginning of the academic year, they were not known what is LEAD, not known what is MP, not known what is Queen's English, not known what is CCS. But today, they were completely trained. They were completely trained in all the aspects, and they stand proudly in the class and give the best education. So I thank all my staff members, I thank all my parents, and I thank each and everybody to be the part of this academic year 23-24. And with your prayers and with your hope and with your cooperation, we would still exceed our next academic year 24 and 25 with a great heights and great achievements. So thank you once again. Thank you one and all. And thank you for giving this opportunity also to express my feelings and experience with all the parents and the students. Thank you one and all.